have this as their freedom from a world that, you know, sometimes may distract them negatively. It means so much to me to be part of it. You rolling with me, 10, 20, 30 years ago, to put your life on the line to fight for your children, your sisters, your family, most importantly, this great country. Embrace this moment. Okay. I want to see all of you fight the pucks in the corners. I want to see you all fight the pucks in the head. I want to see you all fight for every shift of every period without backing down. Do not let up. Not now. Not tomorrow. Never. I want them to go. Let's go out. Let's go out.
It's very good for those of us with health issues. It's profound. It's very meaningful to me. I have severe PTSD. So this is extremely meaningful to me. It's very important.
It means that we have, you know, more veterans. Some have some issues, small, big ones. And it means a lot to be invited to such a tournament. Who are just amazing guys.
It's exciting to see kind of how evenly matched everyone is, how like everyone takes it very serious and we're competitive but still having a great time together and smiling regardless of the outcome, everyone's having fun.
The Warriors have given me a sense of purpose and direction to put out passion and ambitious on the defense and find innovative ways to help individuals. Personally, I've met some of my best friends here. It really is just a group to play hockey together with the movie. It's more than that. It's about our families. It's about our friends. It's about getting back together. That's what it means to me.
I would say if there's one sentence described to the Warriors, it would be veterans back on a mission. And that mission is to help each other and help the group.
Thank you. gentlemen, we are live for a special broadcast here on the LI Sports Network. We're at the Long Beach Ice Arena, and we're here for two games today. The first, the Toronto Fire Hockey Club and the Nassau County Police Department. It's going to be a special day here this afternoon. Of Gerrin Hagen. Warm-ups concluding here at Long Beach between the Toronto Fire Hockey Club and Nassau County. Officials stepping onto the ice now. We're gonna get, we'll be coming out and puck drop by FDNY Lieutenant and Nassau County Legislator Pat Mullaney. Travis Quigley and Jack Ziskin here taking you through the call this afternoon. Jack, special day down here in Long Beach, really exciting day, and I think we're all here for the same reason to celebrate the life of Gerrin Hagen and to watch some very good competitive hockey as well.
Well, it's going to be a tremendous game, and really excited to be here and really excited to pay the tribute to his memory that Gerrin deserves.
Both teams are now lining up on the respective blue lines. So we're going to take a quick pause here, turn things over to the public address announcer and the playing of the national anthem.
We're back on the LI Sports Network following the playing of the Canadian and American national anthems. Toronto Fire Hockey Club, Nassau County Police Department getting set for the first of two games here today in honor of the memory of Gerrin Hagen, captain of the Long Beach Marines hockey squad number two, as we'll see later on. Every member of the Long Beach Guardians team wearing the number two when they take on FDNY. Following completion of this one, first up, Toronto Fire, Nassau County. Travis Quigley, Jack Ziskin here, taking you through the call. Should be an exciting game, getting ready for puck drop here, period number one. Thank you for tuning in with us here on the LI Sports Network, no matter where you may be. As we get set, little conversation at center ice, and puck is down, ready to go. Nassau County wins the faceoff, and they take possession, trying to stretch the ice early. Both these sides have players that have played hockey at a very high level. As the puck goes out of play, first whistle. We're doing 17-minute periods here in Long Beach. First lucky fan going home with a puck here this afternoon.
And Travis, you mentioned high-level players. It starts with Kevin Dumas, of Long Beach native. 52 points in his final season at the University of New Hampshire. That led the team, a team that included future NHLer, current NHLer, Trevor Van Riemsdyk.
Dumas, very good hockey player, Jack. As Toronto Fire with the puck. A little turnover there. Chance for Nassau now. Shot comes through right into the chest of Toronto goaltender Steve. Toronto winning the puck. Comes off the body there of Jack Radin. Fire at the puck one more time. Trying to go north with it. Stretching the ice. Turned over in the neutral zone. Deflected into the zone now of the Toronto Fire. They're trying to clear. Stretch the red line. It's an opportunity now. Nassau Police changing shot. It is gloved there by the Nassau netminder.
And what that was a great play, stretching the ice, able to create that opportunity in transition. A good job drawing the offensive zone faceoff and a better save on that shot.
Toronto with the puck one more time here. Left-hand corner comes free and now chipped out of the zone by Evan Morrow, held in. Backdoor pass in the skates, unable to get the shot off there. It was Toronto, puck stays in the zone one more time. Nassau looking to get it out now. Skating it out, Kyle Pastany. Kieran Hurley in on the forecheck. Hunter with the saucer pass. Turned over, glove down, and we get a whistle there. Couple minutes gone by here, Jack. Both teams feeling each other out a little bit. Toronto making the long trek down. I want to thank them for making the trip here and for supporting the G2H Foundation. In the face-off now and carried into the corner. Pass behind the net, kicks off a skate. Into the slot, chipped out now. Dumas with it, turning, trying to fend off Rowe. Back for Morrow. Passed forward. Stop behind the net, McKinnon plays it off the wall. Pinching, keeping that one in the zone. Brian Manette, the captain of this Nassau County team. Radcliffe passes it over the left side. Slowly entering the zone. Pass across back door. Broken up. dropped off to the slot. Shot goes into the corner. Picked up one more time. Pass into the top of the circle. Stick lifted out of the zone. Nice defensive play there from Gonsalves. Puck comes out front. Nothing doing there. Geichis, the goalie for Nassau County, poked it away. Nassau County now skating it out. Coming in wide, unable to handle the pass there. It's John Peace. It's still in the zone, chipped in deep. Gonsalves leaves it off. Carrying it, Regan. Slap shot from the point, that goes wide. Off the back kick plate. Poked off the stick, staying with it though. Stubba tries to sauce it up to the point. Whitehead pokes it out of the zone. Nassau County regrouping.
Some good job by Nassau County getting some sustained pressure for what feels like the first time in a long time.
Regan with it, tries to sauce it through, broken up. Waters carrying it now. Station 333 Front Street, 1 year on, Marshall Waters looking to go end to end here. Still with possession of the puck, Waters sends it to the front, it's poked away there by Stubba. Stubba on the forehand, chips it off the wall. Peace tries to get it out, he does succeed. Now LeBlanc with a little head fake, poked off his stick, fighting for possession. Nassau wins it. Shot on goal, off the side of the net, pass out front, cleared away there by McBay. It's in the corner now. Spinning off. Backhand pass out front, one-timer, fanning on that one, Robert Wendell. Nassau applying the pressure here, and it's chipped out of the zone. Eric Hanna giving chase, comes in with a chance, takes a shot, that gets deflected, goes off the boards. Sent up top, shot gets blocked there. LeBlanc, his shot gets blocked. A couple block shots in a row there from the Nassau County Police Department.
Well, we've seen a lot of shot attempts in this game, a lot of blocks too.
Toe drag, Rudy Salmonte trying to get through, unsuccessful. Nassau with it one more time. Rushing up the ice with the puck. Steve Azara dangles, comes back to the forehand, couldn't finish. Hits the crossbar, net comes off, and we get a whistle there. Nice speed, nice mitts there from Azara.
Great move, just couldn't get the shot off there, and you gotta like what you've seen these last couple minutes from Nassau County. Not necessarily the start they were looking for, but definitely generating some chances here.
Yeah, I played with Steve Azara back in the day, Jack, and he's always had good hands, good speed, and as you can see, he's still got a little bit of it.
Well, it's 6 degrees of Travis Quigley, I suppose.
Chipped forward, off the skates and into the corner now. Zara in on the forecheck. Rimmed around by John Ohashi. Battle at the blue line. Still in the zone, chipped out one more time. Zara with it, sends it in deep. Swarbrick comes out, leaves it back there for Corneliuson. Plays it forward. Hanna comes in wide, right wing side, passes to the middle. Chance for the fire, and they can't finish there. Covered up by the Nassau tender, Geichis.
Just over 5 minutes have elapsed. Just 4 shots in this game, 3 for the Fire and 1 for Nassau County. A lot of shot attempts, though.
Nassau County wins the faceoff. Morrow chips it off the boards. Back for Morrow. Assistant captain plays it wide, goes through the legs there of Michael Guerra. Now on the half wall, Spears chips it out. 2-on-2 rush here for Toronto. Fanning on the shot was Spears. Glove down now. Pass across, shot goes wide. Good east-west pass there from Toronto. They're starting to get the puck moving. Rimmed around, it's going to go all the way down. No icing, gets waved off, so Hayden Lamb's going to go back, pick it up. He's got plenty of time. Stretches the ice, it's picked off. Toronto regains possession, back behind the net one more time. Lamb has it, moves it forward, no pressure. Whitehead skates it in. Whitehead makes a move, tries to one-hand it to the center of the ice, wouldn't go, it's still behind the net now. Comes around the boards and out. Marshall Waters back to chase after it. D to D. Puck goes forward on a saucer pass, hits Whitehead on the blue line. Takes a shot, save made by Geichis.
Good start for the Nassau County netminder.
Made a couple of big saves so far. Keeping Toronto off the board as Toronto forces a turnover, keeping the puck in the zone. Pass to the high slot. Nice defensive play there by Pistani. Swarbrick comes way out of the net, plays it. Dangerous play, but it goes forward. And Toronto ahead on a rush. Blocker save by Geichis. Pass goes through across the ice. Diving to keep it into the zone. Comes out now, picking it up on the blue line. Gumas drops it in backhand. Kieran Hurley on the forecheck, plays it over. Hurley gets it back. Another Long Beach native. Pass back door, it's intercepted. McBay plays it ahead. Forward, and it's a breakaway for Toronto. Shot missing the net there. Geichis might have got a piece of it with his stick. Now a chance for Nassau on the breakaway. Coming in on the backhand, forehand, five-hole save made by Swarbrick. Both goaltenders standing tall there.
Game opening up a bit. Back-to-back breakaways, back-to-back saves for both netminders.
So Monty plays it ahead. Regan trying to get there, unsuccessful. Corneliuson tries to chip it out, but a strong Nassau forecheck keeps it in. Toronto gets it out now. Rowe trying to make a move. Capizzuto poke checks that one off his stick. In the Nassau end now, behind the net, coming around on the backhand, dropped off. Oshani has to play it into the corner. Rudy Salmonte. Pass across, it gets out of the zone. It's going to be a foot race for it. Pass across, back for Salmonte. Salmonte shot, right toe save made by Swarbrick. Salmonte again, pass to the middle. Morrow has it. Morrow winds, fires off a body and into the netting. At a play, we get a whistle. 8:11 to go here in the first period. Nassau County, Toronto Fire, both zeros on the board. And Jack, good play so far from Steve Swarbrick and Steve Geichis. Both Steves in the net.
And I really like that save from Swarbrick. One thing Toronto's going to have to look out for is those rebounds. There was a golden opportunity on the back door for Nassau County that time.
Morrow's shot gets through and the rebound is poked wide. Lamb trying to chip it out, goes back there for Fajarski. Fajarski, pressure applied on him. Nice defensive play behind the net. Toronto now trying to get it out. Dished over for Matt Whitehead. Whitehead cuts to the middle. Pass back door off some feet. Geichis covers it up. And Matt Whitehead, station 343, Hendrick St. Clair. He's been on for 5 years, Jack, and played at the highest level, I'd say, of anybody on this Toronto Fire roster. Played in the East Coast Hockey League. And you can tell he's got a lot of skill, smooth skater.
Absolutely. And really, he's done a great job today for Toronto. A lot of their offense is coming from him.
Nassau with a chance now. Nice defensive play there by Hayden Lamb. It's chipped out. Morrow in the neutral zone puts it off the wall, and it's picked back up by Toronto. Hannah drops it off. Now Nassau with a chance here one more time. Carrying in, shot on goal. Glove save made by Swarbrick. Good chance coming off the bench there for Jack Radin.
Well, former Farmingdale State College ACHA player. Drove to the net that time, used his size, and was able to create a pretty solid scoring opportunity.
You're hearing the Radin name a lot today. Jack here on the Nassau County team. We got three Radins on the Long Beach Guardians. Jack gloves it down, backhand across. A little high there for Azara. Azara spins and fires one across one more time. Back in the corner here. Hannah behind the net, plays it back to where it came from. Radin and Waters battling. Radin wins it. Guerra back door. Pops up, still loose, 50-50. Ryan plays it out of the zone. Fitzpatrick now drops it back there now for Tyler McBay. McBay cuts to the outside. carries in. Shot off the feet of Geiches, trying to beat him there on the angle. It's flipped all the way down and out of the zone by Azara. Going to be the first icing of the game here, Jack, with 6 minutes, 14 seconds to go. Still goose eggs on the board, but a really good contest here between these two sides. And like I said a couple times, all here for a great reason, a great cause, supporting Gerrin Hagen and the G2H Foundation.
And that was Tyler McBay on that last shot, former BCHL player. So, again, a lot of high-end talent in this game, and McBay going to be a key part of Toronto's efforts here tonight.
Nassau carries in. Chance there. Waters breaks it up. Azara gets his stick lifted by Waters now as he was trying to drive to the net. Fitzpatrick across for McBay, like Jack just mentioned. McBay, junior hockey in the British Columbia Hockey League. High level there. Kieran Hurley goes around the wall. In the feet, Capizzuto. Capizzuto sauces it ahead. And Capizzuto is one of Gerrin Hagen's coaches for the Long Island Gulls AAA 18U team. Azara took the body there, plays it to the point. Capizzuto over, one-timer, Solmonte misses the net. Good chance there for Nassau. Capizzuto fires at the net one more time, blocked away. Looked like it came off the stick of Steve Cornelison. Solmonte up top, Azara poked off his stick and out of the zone. Chance for Toronto, almost a breakaway opportunity there for Marshall, ends up being a delayed offsides.
And that delayed offsides is kind of a gift for Nassau County there, gave him time to regroup.
Dumas had a chance, wouldn't go. Marshall knocks it off the stick. He's trying to get it out of the zone. He succeeds, battle in front of his own bench. Plays it through the middle and it's turned over. Kieran Hurley on the backhand. Elects not to shoot, curls back, creates some space for himself, and his pass across goes off the skates of Solmonte. Foot race for it. Mara plays it off the wall, comes out of the zone. Almost a big chance there for Toronto, forcing that turnover was Eric LeBlanc. Shot gets blocked by Lamb in the corner. Pistani picks it up. Gumas in on the forecheck. Couldn't draw nothing. Toronto back out of the zone. LeBlanc hits the high guy. Backhand toe drag shot. Save made there by Geiches. Flipped out. Nassau looking to respond. Poked away by Lamb. Whitehead sauce one forward over the stick of LeBlanc. Mauro steps up. Carries in. Tries to go backhand forehand under the triangle. Wouldn't go. McKinnon with a nice defensive play. Two on two in the corner. Fire going to come out with it. LeBlanc doesn't get it out of the zone. Nice play by Gonsalves, stepping up, holding the wall. Toronto still looking to clear. It's picked off in the middle by Tim Regan. Regan over the blue line to the backhand, poked away, picks it back up. Little head fake shimmy created some space. Turnover though, back in under the goal line. Regan, Lamb foot race. Lamb wins it, puts it off the glass and out of the zone. Monette played it ahead. Stubba trying to put it deep. LeBlanc in there working for it. And now it's chipped out of the zone the rest of the way by Steve Radcliffe. Nassau trying to break in as we got 2 minutes and 45 seconds to go here in the first period. Hunter over the blue line, shot. Save is made by Steve Geiches. Hits him right in the logo. Still nothing, nothing on the scoreboard. 2:42 remaining here in period number one. Fire Hockey Club here. And don't forget, after this one, FDNY Long Beach Guardians. Two really exciting contests here, all supporting the G2H Foundation, honoring Gerrin Hagen. Waters at the blue line takes a shot. Kick save made by Geiches. Waters winds and fires. That one goes wide. Big slap shot there from the defenseman, Marshall Waters. It's rimmed around. McBay's going to step up and keep it in the zone. It's turned over. His pass to the front in the skates. And now trying to put it forward was Fujarski. It was turned back over, dumped in. Geiches steers it behind his net. Right in front of that Zamboni door, Matthew Grogan. Grogan plays it around. Nassau looking to vacate their end. Puck pops up in the air, and now Toronto going on the attack. Shot comes through. Blocker save. Puck still loose in the slot. Clearing attempt wouldn't go. Toronto putting the pressure on last couple of minutes. Wines fires. That one goes wide. Big slap shot there.
Well, they've already got a dozen shots in this game. They're out shooting Nassau County significantly, and they played last night. It seems like maybe at the beginning of the game that had a bit of an effect on them, but they've really found their legs here.
Stretch pass off the boards, doesn't find any tape, goes down for an icing. I think Corneliuson was looking for the stick. I believe that was John Ohashi who was looking for stretching the ice there. Krasnowski in to take the faceoff. Going up against Jack Radin. Radin initially wins it, but Krasnowski gets it back. Radin, after it was won to the half wall, chipped it in deep. Corneliuson tries to chip it out. Azara knocks it down to the middle. Radin, one-timer over the glass, over the net, pardon me, off the glass. Rolling puck there.
A lot of heavily contested shots here for Nassau County. Not a ton of clean looks, and it shows on both the shot count and the scoreboard right now.
And we're into the final minute here. Delayed offsides going against Toronto Fire. 45 seconds left on the clock. Rudy Salmonti carrying it ahead. Cuts back to the middle. On his backhand. Wide. Stick lifted there by Lamb, but he gets the puck back. Spins off. Passes it forward looking for Radin. Azara coming in off the point. Tries to go to the backhand. Knocked away by Hannah. Hannah leaves it for Whitehead. Matt Whitehead entering the zone. 22 seconds on the clock. Drop for Hannah. Hanno's one-timer off a body in behind the net. Salmonti tries to chip it. It's held in the zone. Off a body there. Salmonti one more time looking to get it out. 10 seconds left. Still in the zone. Toronto in the corner. Skips over the stick. Comes around the wall. 2-1. That's going to do it for the first period here in Long Beach. Nassau County Police Department 0, Toronto Fire 0.
And at the end of that period, it was all about Toronto. The shots were 7-5 around the midway mark of the period. Toronto, however, gets the last six of the period. They control possession. And even though they're not up on the scoreboard, you got to think that NCPD would have liked a little bit better showing there in the final 7 minutes of the period.
And while we have a moment here during intermission, for those watching on the broadcast who may not be local, may not know who Gerrin Hagen was, Gerrin Hagen was a lifelong resident here in Long Beach and tragically had his life cut short last year, January 2023. He was a member of the Long Beach hockey team, member of the Long Beach lacrosse team, and he cherished representing Long Beach. And as he said in his word, defending his island. He was also a Long Beach lifeguard, and he gravitated to the serious responsibilities that came with being a lifeguard. He worked hard to ensure that his training would not fail him and those around him. And we're here today celebrating the life of Gerrin Hagen, as we should. He was a friend to all, and the G2H Foundation supports schools, sports, scholarships. There's a scholarship in Gerrin's memory at Long Beach High School, Nassau BOCES, the Long Beach Lifeguard Patrol, and in the New York Islanders High School Hockey League. New York Islanders High School Hockey League, where also Gerrin was a member of the Long Beach team, played in the league.
He was their captain.
He was the captain of that team, Jack. You are 100% right. Played with a couple of members of the Long Beach Guardians team that we're going to see later on this afternoon. Won a state title with those players. Won a Nassau County Championship with those players, Jack. A lot of fond memories of Gerrin Hagen in this building, in this community. And I want to thank, obviously, the Nassau County Police Department, local here, coming out to play this game today. And, of course, I want to thank the Toronto Fire Hockey Club making the trek down here from Canada to support the G2H Foundation to play in this game. It's absolutely tremendous. Means a lot to this community as we're ready to go for period number two. Travis Quigley, Jack Ziskin on the call here for this game between the Toronto Fire Hockey Club, Nassau County. Team switch sides, nothing in the first period. I'm sure, Jack, they're both going to be looking to get something on that scoreboard as Kieran Hurley had it knocked off his stick. Pass comes ahead, and Toronto looking to get something happening. Poked away, but picking the puck back up. Wrapping around the net to the point. It's picked off, and Gumas going in on a breakaway. Kevin Gumas shot off the glove and out of play. Might have gone off the crossbar there. A little bit tough to see from our angle.
Let's roll the replay on that then.
We'll see if we can get a replay there, but what a shot.
And that's an absolute rocket from the former Lehigh Phantom. You can't give a former AHL player that kind of time and space.
That was a good read. He picked off the pass here in his own end. Went in on the breakaway. You got to give Swarbrick a lot of credit. Played that breakaway strong. Faceoff stayed inside, and now Toronto's going to try to get the puck out of their own end. They do. Pass across. Toe drag. Shot. Save made. Rebound. Another save is made by Gaitis. And a great opportunity early on in this second period for Toronto. Well, Ian Rowe making a nice move there. Silky Mitch Schoen.
We saw such a beautiful effort by Gumas on that breakaway, but coming back the other end, Toronto dangling through that NCPD defense. Two quick shots, and if not for the heroics of Steve Gaitis, I don't think this is a tie game right now.
Nassau win the faceoff, and now they're trying to get it out of their own end. Skate to stick, walking in Gonsalves. Gonsalves on the backhand, tries to throw it to the net. The battle in behind now. Backhanded over, coming out with it is Toronto. Pass forward, one-on-one opportunity, trying to make another move there was Rowe. Rowe back across, nobody home. Good chance there for Toronto. They got the wheels turning early on in this second period. Nassau looking to clear. Rowe helps hold it in, comes around the wall, off of Grogan's stick. He gets it back now, pressure being applied. Will Hunter there. Grogan, one more time. Battling with Hunter. Spears trying to move it to the point. Gonsalves picked it off. It gets down there, comes down, and puck into the stands. And you can tell the pitch in my voice went up a little bit, Jack, as it came off the wall. Didn't know where that one was going. Could have came down and hit us or hit some of our equipment.
Well, it did look like it was going to land to the right of you, I'll say that much. But
good bounce off that wall.
Favorable one this time for this broadcast.
Shot on goal, went off a stick and over. Spears off the back kick plate. One-timer wouldn't go, is knocked away. Nassau County clears it out. Slide through pass, Somonte comes in wide. Now he's going to pull up. Looking to go to the point, it was knocked away. Ohashi trying to clear, moves it to the half boards. Marshall skates it back into his own zone. Creates some space for himself, puts it off the wall. Somonte keeps it in. Now Toronto gets it out over the red line and then fired in deep off the stick there of Gaitis. Played off the wall by Nassau County defenseman Daniel Capizzuto. Comes out of the zone. Somonte looking to knock it down. Toronto with the high flip. Capizzuto's back to get it. Capizzuto in the corner with it. Plays it off the wall, looking for the tape of Ryan Keane. Keane goes back to Capizzuto. Capizzuto rims it around. Fujarski flips it out. Toronto regains it in the neutral zone. Saucer pass ahead. And a chance here for Toronto. Coming in on the backhand. Couldn't get the shot off. Had Gaitis beat. But unable to get that one through there was Kevin Krasnowski.
Well, the netminder did just enough to take away the angle. The defense did the rest, and another grade-A scoring chance that Toronto can't capitalize.
And a foot race for it now. Toronto with an opportunity. Oh. Puck is still free. Gaitis coming out with the poke check. LeBlanc has possession out front through the slot. Shot comes through. That goes wide. Hit the net. It might have been a goal there, Jack. Looked like Gaitis lost his footing. McKinnon tries to center it. Now we got a battle ensuing in the corner. Somonte picks it up. He's going to use his speed, carry it out of the zone, and now it's a two-on-one for Nassau County. Somonte takes the shot. That one off the glove, goes behind the net. Back and forth action here in Long Beach. 2-on-1 now for Toronto. Backhanded across, poked away by Azar. A good chance there for Radcliffe.
Good work on the back check there. That was the first shot of the period for NCPD. First shot in over 10 minutes.
That shot gets blocked. Big one-timer. Centering pass goes through all the way. And now Nassau have a chance to clear. Skating this one out is Keane. Keane gets taken down, and we're going to get the first penalty of the day. And it's going to be a power play chance now for the Nassau County Police Department.
And this is what they need here. They haven't had a ton of shots on net. They've created a lot of chances in transition, but a really good job closing out those gaps by the Toronto defense. Great back check for them as well, and it's really made it difficult for NCPD to get set in their own zone, start generating chances.
And an opportunity for the first goal of the game doesn't come at a better time. Nassau County on the power play here as they look to break the ice. Unable to set things up cleanly though. Puck gets sent 200 feet. Geitjes out to play it off the glass. Thrown back at the net. Geitjes gets back just in time to steer it back into the corner. Good chance there for Toronto. Puck gets dropped off, and now Gumas going to carry it ahead. He's leading the charge on this Nassau power play. Puck goes up top for Raiden. Raiden walks to the middle. Back over for Gumas. Drops it to Raiden. Raiden back door with a chance. Save made by Swarbrick. Somonte picked up his own rebound. Now back up top with Gumas. Gumas fakes the shot. Spins off to the point. Raiden, shot gets blocked. Chance now for Toronto, and it's a shorthanded breakaway. Coming in, taking the shot, and he scores!
Goal coming for Toronto for a while, a shorthanded breakaway, the 16th shot of the game for Toronto that finds the back of the net, and just picture perfect here. Watch as he comes.
Yeah, you see on the replay. So yeah, like you said, beautiful shot. You see on the replay, he had that blocker side open.
Just a great play by Toronto. They take that early 1-0 lead, Travis, and not what you want on the power play if you're NCPD.
They still got 45 seconds, so a chance to respond. Kieran Hurley enters the zone with the puck. Backhanded, Gumas knocks it down. Back door on this power play. The Nassau Police Department looking to respond after giving up that shorthanded goal. Somonte to the front. Hurley, his shot goes off a stick into the corner. Back out front, and Hurley couldn't redirect it to the cage. Hurley around. Gumas tried to play it up for Capizzuto. It gets sent all the way down the sheet. And that's going to do it for the Nassau County power play. Back to 5-on-5 hockey. Nassau ices the puck. And it's going to be a face-off in their end. 1-0 the score, 10:40 to go here in the second period. Ian Rowe getting Toronto fire on the board with a shorty there on the breakaway.
And that's the type of response you need from Toronto. They controlled the pace of this game before power play began. Now another chance there.
Big chance there. Almost a turnover in the blue paint. Turnover at the point now. Pass back door is picked off. Poked back into the zone. Delayed offsides going against Toronto here. They touch back up. It's sent over. Gonsalves' pass was intercepted. Grogan trying to get it out. He does. Passes behind Gonsalves, and now Toronto with another opportunity. Whitehand trying to go one hand back to his forehand. Wouldn't go. Regan plays it off the glass. Still in the zone. Regan trying to whack at it.
Big save there off the arm, and they're lucky it didn't take a bad bounce going to the net.
Still behind the net of the police department. Comes out to the slot. Gonsalves just whacks at it, gets it out. Forward line going for a change there for the PD. Silky move there. Shot gets blocked, though. Ended up going in behind the net. Going for a change after that great shift was Eric LeBlanc. Toronto behind the net. Hanna. Short pass to the backhand. Ends up backdoor. And pushed aside there by Del Maestro. Comes out. Losing his footing there was Ryan Keane. Pucks back in the Nassau end. Turned over. Chance on the forehand. Save made by Geich's rebound. Puck is still loose. And it's cleared out of the zone. Sent all the way down. Going to be an icing. Going against the Nassau County Police Department. But Jack, last couple of minutes, it's been all Toronto Fire. Geich just making a couple big saves.
And that was a critical one there. And Toronto's just having their way with this NCPD defense. They're carving through them. And now you see a goaltending change. Geich just exits, and it looks like Ryan Mattson will come in to the goal for NCPD.
Like Jack said, goalie change there for Nassau about halfway through the game. First shot that he sees goes wide. McBay holds it in there on the blue line, goes all the way around the wall. Turnover is forced. Nassau trying to clear it. Still in the zone. Comes back behind for the captain, Brian Manette. Morrow stretches the ice way off the boards, but the pass is behind Del Maestro. No icing on the play, so Toronto going to regroup. It's dished over for Tyler McBay. He's going end to end. Nothing doing there. He's poked off his stick. Still loose in the slot. Now back up to the point. Waters fakes the slap shot towards the net. Just sends it back down low. Hanna with the puck. Behind the net. Pass comes out front. Loose in the slot. And jumping to cover that one up. Ryan Mattson. We get a whistle on the play there. 7:58 to go here. Second period. Toronto on top. 1-0. We're here honoring Gerrin Hagen, the G2H Foundation. At the Long Beach Arena, Long Beach, New York, Travis Quigley, Jack Ziskin. You're watching live on the LI Sports Network. Toronto win the faceoff. Pushed aside there by Mattson. Toronto holds it in, though. Nassau looking clear one more time. Samonte with the head fake. Chips it ahead. Samonte gets that one right back from Guerra. Now he enters the zone. Samonte cuts to the middle, drops it back off. On the backhand, shot comes through, save it.
Minder, 7:30 remaining in the second period. He hasn't faced a ton of shots, but Travis, if you want to talk about the pace, the tempo, who's controlling this game, Toronto's out shooting NCPD 21-8.
And Guerra's shot got blocked there after Nassau won the faceoff. One-timer opportunity for him. Unable to get out of the zone. Jack Radin with the puck. Dylan Radin just crossed in front of us, Jack, as he's getting ready for the game after this one. They'll be playing for the Long Beach Guardians.
And that's a roster that has a lot of Garen's old teammates on it. Luke Judge, who has had a, I don't want to call it a cup of coffee with the LI Sports Network, but he's been riding shotgun with you for the majority of the season, it feels like.
That's my number one color guy right there. Excited to see him play later on. Kevin Brand coming by us right now. He's getting ready for the game later.
Also, I think this is the first game I've done color for you as opposed to the other way around, so it's kind of nice doing it this way. A lot less pressure.
Nassau with a chance here. Solmonte's shot gets blocked. Still with possession. Swarbrick knocks away the pass in front. It goes out of the zone, and Capizzuto gets possession of it. Radin plays it across. Guerra unable to chip it in and maintain possession. He was able to fight it in. Toronto clear it out. Chance now for the Fire. Capizzuto, really strong defensive play there. Stretches the ice, looking to hit Pistani on the far blue line. It skipped his stick. Nassau, though, with numbers. Pass out front. No tape in the slot. Goes all the way to the point for Capizzuto. Spins off. Has it on the backhand. Plays it into the corner. Taken down there by a diving Azara. No call on the play. Radcliffe cycles it in for LeBlanc. LeBlanc to the middle. Finds a way through to the point. Walking in. Toe drag shot. Goes off a stick and into the netting. Good chance there. Coming off the bench, number 28 for Toronto. Keep saying his name, Jack. Matt Whitehead.
Well, that was a great play by the former ECHL player. Actually had his arm up on that one, too. So old habits die hard, I suppose. Wanted a penalty for tripping on that odd man rush. I believe that was LeBlanc who carried it in that time, too.
Toronto win the faceoff. Shot gets blocked out front. Cleared out of the crease by Kieran Hurley.
That's a big positional save.
Now it's in that left side corner. Puck pops off the glass and out of play. And Jack, if I'm not mistaken, I want to say, we got it zoomed in right there. Catch was made by a parent holding their child. Child in the right arm, puck in the left hand. Great play there.
Why'd they throw the puck back, though? They threw the puck back. They have more. Keep it.
Should have kept the puck. That was an impressive play. You deserve to keep the puck after that one.
I guess it's a class act. I don't want to dunk on this guy for throwing it back. But
it's like the guy you saw a couple years ago at a baseball game. He was holding his child, and he caught a home run ball. It's an incredible feat.
It is, and you know, I got to be honest here. I feel like there's a lot of people out there who would catch the ball and drop their child, so I feel like that makes it even more impressive.
Pursued by most, not many succeed. Nassau wins the faceoff there, and 5 minutes, 10 seconds to go here. Period number two comes out of the zone. Swarbrick's going to play it. Puts it off the wall. Waters is there to pick it up. Pushes it over. Now Rowe gets it poked off his stick. Gumas with a chance. Taken down on an opportunity. A little bit of a mini breakaway. Referee's arms up. Hurley's pass out front wouldn't go. Hunter touches the puck. And we get a whistle. Another power play coming here for the Nassau County PD. And Jack didn't go their way the first time. Gave up that shorthanded goal. Ian Rowe is the beneficiary. We'll see how it goes this time around for them as they try to respond, make this a 1-1 game.
And
I think we have a problem with our clock because I said 5 minutes, 10 seconds, and it still says 5 minutes and 10 seconds. Might have been an issue that I did not see.
Well, look, we're all having fun here.
More hockey, I don't care.
Exactly, but maybe this power play may not go their way either, Travis.
2-on-1 shorthanded opportunity for Toronto. Shot, Mattson makes the save right in his breadbasket. And you can see the look on Hanna's face. Didn't get everything on that he was looking for. Maybe not the right placement he was looking for either. But nonetheless, another good shorthanded opportunity there for Toronto Fire. They've really been buzzing in this middle frame.
You said it, Travis. They, What's the term you like to say? Power kill?
Now that they've been practicing the power kill is what I'm seeing. Nassau just having trouble right now breaking the puck out. It's played through the middle of the ice there. Somonte ahead for Gumas. He enters the zone. Back for Pistani. Pistani drops to Somonte. Gumas now. Pressure being applied on him. He rolls up top. Spins and plays it back down low for Somonte, cycled in for Hurley. Hurley to the point. Gumas across Capizzuto for Hurley. Hurley walks. Somonte redirects it towards the net, steered aside there by Swarbrick. Comes back out up top. 55 seconds to go on the power play. 4 minutes remaining here in period number two. Out front, Hurley, one timer, and he scores. Kieran Hurley. Power play goal for the Nassau County PD, and it's a 1-1 game.
And we're going to see the replay here. That's exactly what you need on the power play, just good puck movement leading to that one-timer, and I'll have that for you in just one moment.
You see Hurley just pops out into that bumper spot, gets himself into some free space. And
beautiful.
Nice one-timer there.
Well,
Jack looked like it went through the arm there, right between the blocker and the body.
And that's a tough save for a goaltender to make again, just finding the soft area that time. And if you're Toronto, you probably want to cover that a little bit better.
Saucer pass clean through the middle. Toronto back on the attack. LeBlanc finds Whitehead. Whitehead's shot gets blocked. LeBlanc has possession one more time. Rolls up the wall. Backhand pass wouldn't go. Held in the zone, though. LeBlanc gets it back, loses the handle of it. Back door, blocker save made. by Mattson. Backhand off the mask of Mattson. Gonsalves there to pick it up in the slot, plays it across, it's turned over. Whitehead walks in, fakes the shot on the backhand, that goes over the cage. Good chance there for Whitehead. He knocks it down now in the corner. Backhanded to the slot, it was intercepted. Chipped out of the zone, Cornelson's there to pick it up in neutral. Saucered over, Whitehead makes a move to the backhand, poked away. All started in the neutral zone there with Cornelson, who gets it back. Shot goes through, and that one right into the chest, right off the logo of Ryan Mattson. Fifth precinct for the Nassau County Police Department. I believe Jack mentioned played Farmingdale State ACHA hockey back in the day.
You know it's back in the day because back then they were ACHA. Really strong performance from him. Came in after, I believe,
came in about the midway point.
I think Geitz just made about 16 saves on 17 shots, and Mattson stopped everything he's faced, but Toronto has already fired 9 shots on him.
Battle beneath the goal line, and Matthew Grogan's going to come out with it. Backhands it off the wall. Fujarski plays it ahead. Robert Wendell enters. Fires it at the net. It goes off the back kick plate. Sent in down low one more time by Fujarski. 1-1 game, 2.5 left in the middle frame. We're going to get an ice cut following the completion of this period. Toronto enters 3-on-2. Shot gets blocked by Grogan. It's sent ahead. Fujarski's going to pick it up. Potential odd man rush wouldn't go. Back to pick it up for Toronto is Fitzpatrick. Back to his defense when he played it. And Fitzpatrick's going to pick it right back up now. Another odd man rush. Fires a little half clapper. Save is made by Mattson. He covers up the rebound. And with 2:02 remaining, we get a whistle and now a face-off to the left of Ryan Mattson. Good chance there for Sean Fitzpatrick. Station 311, Yonge Street, St. Clair's been on for 7 years. Actually played football in university, Jack.
You know, I was wondering when we were going to get to that. Hadn't seen an opportunity for that yet. Yeah, I guess he's pretty good at both sports.
Chance for Azara now one-on-one. His shot goes off the stick of McBay. Azara's in on the forecheck. Loses an edge right in front of that Zam door. Nassau come out with it, though. And nice work there by Toronto getting that puck out of the zone. It's backhanded across. One-touch pass. A little give and go ends up in the corner. Guerra backhands it, goes out of the zone. Marshall's there to pick it up for Toronto. 1:15 remaining in the second period. Waters with it now. Skates to the middle of the ice. Look at him move it D to D. Azara, F1, playing Waters hard. Centering pass goes all the way through. It's held in the zone by Capizzuto. Capizzuto, back door off the stick of Jack Radin. Marshall gets it out, backhands it ahead. 3-on-2 now for Toronto. Outside shot, that one goes wide. Held at the red line there, I should say, by Cornelison. He flips it back in, 35 seconds remaining. Stretch pass for Gumas, off the backhand there of Pistani into the zone.
And Travis, I think the word we're looking for here is crisp. If you're an NCPD, they got to get these passes tape to tape.
Monette stops behind the net, 15 seconds remaining. Saucer pass up in the air. Hurley bats it down. It's played forward. Morrow, 5 seconds. Shot goes over the net. One more chance for Nassau. Fired and blocked in front, and that's going to do it for period number 2 here at the Long Beach Arena. Really tight contest here, Jack, between these two teams. 1-1 is the score following 34 minutes of action played here.
And Travis, I think this is a game that's been defined by goaltending and odd man rushes. A lot of odd man rushes for Toronto, a lot of shots coming off them. And NCPD has had their chances, but they haven't necessarily gotten as many shots as they have shot attempts.
Yeah, Jack, I think it all started kind of with that shorthanded goal Toronto scored. kind of open the ice up a little bit for both teams. Like you said, Nassau, big power play goal to respond there. Good two periods between these two sides. I want to thank both of them, obviously. First, Nassau County Police Department, local PD coming down here to Long Beach to play this game, supporting the G2H Foundation. Thank everybody on the team and on the service for what they do. Same goes to the Toronto Fire Hockey Club. Want to thank them for their service. Want to thank them for making the trip down here to Long Beach to support the G2H Foundation and be a part of this great event that we have here today. Like you mentioned, Jack, we're here. We're celebrating Gerrin Hagen, the captain of the Long Beach squad. Number two, as we said, forever number two. You see it displayed around the rink here in Long Beach. And just a great cause that we're here for, the G2H Foundation. We set scholarships in Garrett's memory at Long Beach High School, at the Nassau Bosey's Technical Education Center, the Long Beach Lifeguard Patrol, again, scholarship in Garrett's name, NYIHSHL, where Gerrin played, part of that. Also, G2H Foundation going to be supporting hockey programs like the Long Island Rough Riders Sled Hockey, the New York Metro Blind Hockey, Long Island Blues Special Hockey, the Long Island Warriors Vets Hockey, and of course, the Long Beach Middle School Club Hockey.
And it's been a fun one, I think, Travis, that it's sometimes a little hard to talk about, honestly, because his life was cut tragically short. It's hard for, obviously, his parents, and you got to give everyone involved a lot of credit for trying to honor his memory in a way that I'm sure, looking down on us, he can be proud of.
Yeah, and like we said, Gerrin was a friend to all of us. He was a member of this community that was cherished, will forever be remembered, an important member of this community, and we are proud to be here supporting him today, supporting his family, supporting the G2H Foundation. Again, want to thank Toronto Fire Hockey Club for coming down here, being a part of this event today. The Nassau County PD, want to thank them as well. 1-1 the score between these two sides. It's the second intermission, so we're going to take a little break here. Don't go anywhere. Stay tuned in with us here on the LI Sports Network. Follow us on all of our social medias. You won't miss a second of any of the content that we have. YouTube, of course, subscribe there as well. Travis Quigley, Jack Ziskin, LI Sports Network. Again, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be back in about 9 minutes or so with the third period of this one.
These heroes, these athletes, these warriors, you know, they're normal people, just like everybody else. They've dealt with a lot, you know, and to have this as their escape, to have this as their freedom from a world that, you know, sometimes may distract them negatively, it means so much to me to be a part of it for them. You all enlisted 10, 20, 30 years ago to put your lives on the line, to fight for your brothers, your sisters, your family, most importantly, this great nation. Embrace this moment. Okay? I want to see all of you fight for the pucks in the corners. I want to see you all fight for the puck in front of the net. I want to see you all fight for every shift of every period without backing down. Do not let up. Not now, not tomorrow, never. Got one thing. Let's go out there and let's show everybody who the Warriors are.
The Long Island Warriors Summer Shootout is just an annual tournament that we have every August. It's with the support of the New York Islanders. We try to bring in veterans teams, specifically Warriors teams from all over the country.
It's actually our first ever international tournament. We got the team from Denmark to come over.
Then we also, you know, bring in some local teams, first responder teams. We have a competitive tournament with different skill levels and divisions.
It's a mutual bonding event for first responders, veterans, It's a place where we can get together, where you're part of a group, even though you're not on the same team. You still have a like mindset, and that's just a huge brotherhood out here, and that's what draws us.
It's very good for those of us with the mental health issues. It's profound. It's very meaningful to me. I have severe PTSD, so this is extremely meaningful to me. It's very important.
It means that we are all veterans. Some have some issues, small, big ones. And it means a lot to be invited to such a tournament and to come over and just play some ice hockey.
It's been exciting to see kind of how evenly matched everyone is and how like everyone takes it very serious and very competitive, but still having a great time together, smiling regardless of the outcome. Everyone's having fun.
The Warriors have given me a sense of purpose and direction to what I'm passionate about, which is helping veterans and finding innovative ways to help veterans.
Personally, I've met some of my best friends here. It really is just a group of play hockey together, but really it's more than that. It's about our families, it's about our friends, it's about getting back together. That's what it means to me.
I would say if there was one sentence to describe the Warriors, it would be veterans back on a mission. And that mission is to help each other and help the community.
Ready, two.
The mission of the Long Island Warriors hockey program is to provide the sport of hockey to veterans and especially returning service members to have that sense of camaraderie, physical fitness, and organization again, as well as giving back to the community.
What we've learned is through the VA studies and other national studies is that physical exercise and camaraderie and bringing the team together really helps with that transition. As you look at a lot of these individuals who are coming out of the service, the transition is the hardest part.
So the program was started in 2020 by Robert Schrembri. It's been a nationwide program through USA Hockey and was missing in the Long Island community. Currently, the Warriors has close to 90 members, and we currently have three teams in three different tiers. The greatest compliment I ever heard has actually been from people outside of the Warriors, whether it's an opposing team that said, oh, you guys have been playing together for years, and some of us have only met months ago. And family members have said that, you know, their husbands or loved ones are healthier, they're happier, they're sleeping better, and it's clear that it's working.
It's fantastic. It's a whole support system. It's not just hockey. Hockey's the medium that we play in, but, you know, I've spent countless hours on the phone talking with guys. Some of them were pretty distraught, and, you know, this is what keeps us together, keeps some of them alive.
It's very supportive, you know, no matter what your level is. They were very supportive of me, very helpful, and lifted up my spirits, really got me into hockey.
These heroes, these athletes, these warriors, you know, they're normal people, just like everybody else. They've dealt with a lot, you know, and to have this as their escape, to have this as their freedom from a world that, you know, sometimes may distract them negatively, it means so much to me to be a part of it for them.
You all enlisted 10, 20, 30 years ago to put your lives on the line to fight for your brothers, your sisters, your family, most importantly, this great nation. Embrace this moment. Okay? I want to see all of you fight for the pucks in the corners. I want to see you all fight for the puck in front of the net. I want to see you all fight for every shift of every period without backing down. Do not let up. Not now, not tomorrow, never. Got one thing. Let's go out there and let's show everybody who the Warriors are.
The Long Island Warriors Summer Shootout is just an annual tournament that we have every August. It's with the support of the New York Islanders. We try to bring in veterans teams, specifically Warriors teams from all over the country.
It's actually our first ever international tournament. We got the team from Denmark to come over.
Then we also, you know, bring in some local teams, first responder teams. We have a competitive tournament with different skill levels and divisions.
It's a mutual bonding event for first responders, veterans. It's a place where we can get together, where you're part of a group, even though you're not on the same team. You still have a like mindset, and that's just a huge brotherhood out here, and that's what draws us. It's very good for those of us with the mental health issues. It's profound. It's very meaningful to me. I have severe PTSD, so this is extremely meaningful to me. It's very important.
It means that we are all veterans. Some have some issues, small, big ones. And it means a lot to be invited to such a tournament and to come over and just play some ice hockey.
It's been exciting to see kind of how evenly matched everyone is and how like everyone takes it very serious and very competitive, but still having a great time together, smiling regardless of the outcome. Everyone's having fun.
The Warriors have given me
suppose we are. Toronto carrying the puck into the zone. Centering pass out front. Save made there by Mattson. Whistle blows. 16:37 remaining in the period.
There's 23 seconds going by here. Fresh sheet of ice for the Toronto Fire Hockey Club, Nassau County Police Department. Travis Quigley, Jack Ziskin, LI Sports Network. Waters couldn't get the shot through, so he puts it into the corner. Nassau now looking to clear. Carrying the puck forward, Somonte. Somonte backhands it over. Ice still a little wet there. He saw the puck sticking just a little bit. McBay now stretches the ice. Here's a chance. Whitehead coming in on a breakaway. Whitehead shoots off the post.
Big chance there for Toronto Fire. Not what you want if you're NCPD to start this period off.
Stretch pass across the ice was picked off. Toronto has possession again. Raiden in on the forecheck. Toronto now moving up the ice. Shot from the outside, turned away by Mattson. Rebounds behind the net. Corneliusson can't keep it in. Swarbrick leaves it for him. Stretch pass, Kieran Hurley's there to pick it off. Tries to backhand it into the zone. Hunter collects, walks in, takes a shot. That one misses the blocker side of Mattson, rimmed around the wall. Evan Morrow in there, backhanded ahead. Nassau trying to clear one more time. Captain Brian Manette played it forward. Stretch pass looking for Gumas on a breakaway. Was picked off. Kieran Hurley intercepts now. Chips it off the wall. Gumas enters. One-on-one turning into a little two-on-two. Hooked in front was Pistani as he was trying to stuff it home. And it's going to be a third power play here for the PD.
And to their credit, they've done a great job of that. They've drawn three penalties, which is a bit of a rarity in this event, Travis. I'm a little surprised by that so far.
Yeah, Will Hunter to the box there for hooking Nassau. Third power play here. They're 1-for-2. Gave up a shorty on the first one. They were able to capitalize on the second. Kieran Hurley now walking in. Trying to find Solmonte. Gets his stick lifted. Now Waters leading the charge. Two-on-one rush here for Toronto, but they're offsides.
And if you're NCPD, you got to maintain possession a little bit cleaner. But again, we're all here to have fun. And it's been a great event so far. It's been a really good game.
Yeah, 1-1 the score. Nassau still with a minute 35 to go here on their power play. Solmonte carries into the zone. His pass couldn't find the tape of Pistani, and it's sent all the way down now by Kevin Krasnowski. Krasnowski, station 226. Maine and Girard, 2 years on, played U Sports in Canada. Jack, that's kind of like our equivalent NCAA. A lot of good players in U Sports. Coming from the Canadian Hockey League, major juniors.
And they've been talking about giving those guys NCAA eligibility, so maybe something to look forward to at the collegiate level. But again, a lot of good teams. I mean, and you'll see them beat NCAA teams from time to time, too.
A lot of exhibitions between NCAA schools and U Sports schools as Zara chips it ahead for Solmonte. Rolling puck bounced over his stick. He's in on the forecheck now. 43 seconds remaining here on this power play for Nassau. 1-1 the score. Azara pulls it out of that scuffle. Corneliusson chips it around Solmonte. He's going to carry it ahead now. Sauces one forward, looking for the tape of Whitehead. He collects. He's on a breakaway. Forehand, backhand, trying to stuff a five hole. Mattson making the save.
Big stop there, and Toronto's 30th shot at the game, if I'm not mistaken.
Another shorthanded opportunity there for the Toronto Fire Hockey Club. Ooh. Raiden collects it.
I don't know if you saw that behind the play, Travis, but Steve, I believe that was Corneliusson who ended up having a collision at the blue line. He's in some discomfort outside his own zone.
And I had my eyes on the puck, Jack. I happened to miss that one. The whistle there. Hopefully Steve Cornelison's all right. Faceoff looks like it's going to stay inside the Toronto Fire zone here. 12:54 to go in the third period of this one. Score is 1-1 between these two sides. And Jack, you happen to see that one?
Yeah, it was just a collision after the play was made outside the zone. There was some excitement on the Toronto bench, but I think for the most part they realized it was pretty much incidental contact type of play.
Yeah. charity day here. Here's support of the G2H Foundation. Don't think we're going to see anything purposeful here, Jack. We're all here playing the game that we love and playing the game that Gerrin loved.
That's what it's all about.
As Jack Radin backhands that one into the zone. We're back to 5-8 off the shoulder there of Mattson. Good shot there in the high slot.
And as we mentioned, there were 17 shots against the netminder Geitschus. There's been 14 against Mattson, and Mattson saved all of them. Just one goal apiece for each squad.
Toronto looking to keep the foot on the gas here, keep applying the pressure after killing off that penalty. Intercepted there by Azara. Clearing attempt to win it go. LeBlanc holds it in. Shot, rebound, backhand, scores! On the board, 2-1 game in favor of the Toronto Fire.
And that's exactly what you want if you're Toronto. Go to the net, good things happen. It took them 18 attempts. Correction, my apologies. It took them 16 attempts to find the back of the net here. And that's just picture perfect backhand rebound there from, I believe that was Krasnowski, correct?
Yep, Kevin Krasnowski in front there, the beneficiary, collecting the rebound off the pad. Good shot from the high slot from Eric LeBlanc. And Toronto Fire now take the lead over the Nassau County PD. It's 2-1, 12 minutes to go here. Dumping off the glove of Mattson. Cleared out now, Regan giving chase, McBay. Felt the pressure, sent it right out of his end. Mattson stops it up, collects, and fires a pass forward. Stays in the zone. Chipped ahead now, knocked down. Nassau looking to take it out over the red line and now chipped in deep. Ryan Keane on the forecheck. Swarbrick out to rim it around. It's picked off. Regan looking to work his way to the net with the puck. It was poked away. Fitzpatrick has it in the neutral zone. Knocked off his stick. Glove down, a big collision there. Keane felt that one, took a big hit from, looked like that was Neil Ryan who threw that one. Stretch pass, Regan coming in on the backhand, tries to play it out. Nobody home, comes out into the neutral zone. Hannah picks it up, and we get a whistle, penalty called, and it looks like Nassau is going to be going back onto the power play, I believe.
And This feels like a must score here, Travis. They've drawn a lot of penalties to their credit. And it's a friendly match. I suppose it's not that friendly in some cases, but
it's Neil Ryan who's going to the box. And I was kind of following that as the play was going on there. Neil Ryan was the one who threw that big hit there on Ryan Keane. Keane didn't like it. They were having a little bit of a conversation. And I want to say Keane kind of baited Ryan into taking that penalty, and happens at all levels, Jack. You still see it even in this charity game as Nassau another power play chance here. Gumas dragging a couple defenders to him, lays it off for Capizzuto. Capizzuto behind the net. Pistani back to Capizzuto. Capizzuto with it on the half boards. Down low one more time, out front for Hurley. His one-timer goes off a stick. In behind one more time with Pistani. Hurley into help now. Battle there, and Toronto's able to clear it out.
And this has got to be a difficult game for Dan Capizzuto, who coached Gerrin for the Long Island Goals AAA U18 team. That was his one of his last travel coaches. That was during his senior year, I believe.
A lot of connections with Gerrin here in this game, here throughout the day, especially with that Long Beach Guardian side that we're going to see taking on the FDNY after this one. Minute left on the power play here for the Nassau County Police Department as Kieran Hurley chips that one into the zone. Lamb rims it around. It's going to go all the way out. Marrow collects it on his own blue line, trying to regroup quickly. Up ahead for Gumas. Gumas to the middle. Wines fakes the slap shot, comes back on his stick. He one-times it, goes wide. Gumas at the point. Plays it across. Morrow's one-timer off the side of the cage. So Monte cycles it.
And Travis, correct me if I'm wrong, I'm not sure that NCPD has a shot on goal on this power play.
Gumas' shot there went off the side of the net. And it comes out of the zone one more time. 20 seconds to go. I believe they had one early on, Jack, but not much doing for them. Very good penalty kill for the Toronto Fire Hockey Club as they're looking to make it 3-for-4. Just 10 seconds left. Dumas comes in wide. Wraps it around the net to the slot. Solmonte couldn't get a stick on it. It was broken up. And we're back to 5-on-5. Dumas out wide. Guerra dumps it in. McBay back for it. Tries to stretch the ice through the middle for Whitehead. Goes all the way down for an icing. 8:48 to go here in the final period of regulation. 2-1 the score in favor of the Toronto Fire Hockey Club. Nassau looking to respond. Still plenty of time left.
And to their credit, the shot count, and part of this is the power play, but it's been a lot closer this period. 4 shots for Toronto on goal, 3 for NCPD.
And a turnover, Zara trying to fend off a couple of defenders. He does, moves it back out wide. Pass goes underneath his stick. And now LeBlanc, shifty move, carries into the Nassau end, takes a shot off a skate, and goes up out of play into the stands. 8:24 to go. Period number 3. Game 1 of 2 here at the Long Beach Arena as we take a look at the great crowd that we have here in Long Beach. Great turnout for this game between the Toronto Fire Hockey Club and the Nassau County Police Department. You think this is a big turnout, Jack? Wait till 5 o'clock when the Long Beach Guardians are playing the FDNY.
You took the words right out of my mouth. That's going to be electric.
Azara tries to play it across. Cornelison reads that one perfectly. Azara was looking for Jack Radin's tape. Radin has it now, enters the Toronto zone. Tucks the shoulder, one-hands it at the net, puts it off the side of the cage, loses his edge. Nassau still has possession. Poked off Guerra's stick. Azara trying to play the body. Toronto stretching the ice. Whitehead dives. Now has possession of the puck. Great effort there to catch that pass. Now Toronto with an opportunity. LeBlanc on the backhand. Carries around. Sauces it through the middle. Stick lift doesn't go through. Lamb now with the shot deflected. And a glove save is made there by Ryan Mattson. Good chance there for Toronto. After Nassau came down. Had an opportunity themselves there, Jack.
Absolutely, and that's what you need to see if you're Toronto. A good response after back-to-back penalty kills. They were successful, but it can really suck the life out of you. It drains you physically.
Nassau win the faceoff. Capizzuto plays it ahead. Gonsalves trying to chip it in. It's in the feet there of Keane. Kept in by Capizzuto. Turned over one more time. Keane tries to play it at the net. It gets blocked. Capizzuto's shot. Deflected. Save. Rebound. And they score! Tie game. John Peace on the rebound. It's 2-2.
And that's what you need if you're Long Beach. Apologies if you're NCPD. Old habits. Hard to break them. But just a great play. Driving to the net. That first deflection, just battling through to put that one home. That's what they need here. That's the type of play they're going to need to see more of if they're going to pull out a win here.
That was a good shot from the point. Like you said, nice deflection in the high slot by Peace, and then follows it up, gets his own rebound, puts it home. Nassau's got a little extra juice now. Gonsalves one-hands it into the Toronto end. McKinnon plays it off the glass, goes into the netting and out of play. So 7:43 to go here in the third period. We're going to get a faceoff inside the Toronto end. Right after Nassau was able to tie it up 2-2. It was John Peace with the goal, third precinct. And again, Farmingdale State College ACHA alum. Waters, it was in his feet, he finds it. Starts to skate it out, goes D to D over for Tyler McBay. McBay now enters, cuts in wide, shot blocker saved there by Mattson. Solmonte backhands it forward. Pistani looking for Gumas on the breakaway. Missed his tape, and we get an icing call against the Nassau PD.
And Travis, you mentioned it, the clock, it's a bit sticky right now. So there's going to be a little extra time, and a tie game. Be interested to see how that plays out.
left of Mattson. Faceoff is won, so Monte moves it over for Marrow. Marrow looking for Hurley at the far blue. Picked off there. Gumas with a toe drag in the neutral zone. Wines fires. Save made there by Steve Swarbrick.
And Gumas, he's been noticeable all game. They're going to need a lot from him down the stretch. Once again, Gumas is now with the Police Academy, of course, but as I've mentioned several times, played 4 years at the University of New Hampshire, had over 100 points during his collegiate career.
Stretch pass, breakaway for Toronto. On the backhand, save is made by Mattson. Rebound's pushed out. One-timer goes just wide. Waters sends it at the net. Hurley with the block shot. Gumas gloves it down. The two-on-two rush. Over for Hurley. Hurley shoots over the net.
And one of the things that's been costing NCPD a little bit, a lot of shots over the net. They're leading to these pucks that carry them out of the zone.
Tries to slap it out of the zone. Hanna walks in, takes a shot. That goes wide. LeBlanc walks in. Shot, and they score! Toronto takes the lead. Eric LeBlanc.
And we're going to see it on the replay here. And we saw it on the last goal, too. It's about getting pucks to nets. It's about deflections and just a nice shot through traffic. It gets tipped five hole. That is beautiful. That is textbook. And like you said, that's Eric LeBlanc.
Well, LeBlanc took the shot. It was actually Steve Cornelison in front.
The defenseman
who deflected that one in.
Cornelison, NCAA D3, currently STN 222, Warden Eglinton.
Nassau down a goal once again now. Trying to get their offense going one more time. Centering pass is picked off there by Ohashi. He moves it out of the zone. Fitzpatrick skipped over his stick. He elects to dump it in now. Ryan on the forecheck. Nassau trying to clear. They do. It's in the neutral zone. Ohashi wins it back. Sends it in behind the cage of Ryan Mattson. 5:36 to go here. Period number three. Toronto on top 3-2 over the Nassau County Police Department. Deflected in there by Michael Guerra, and Swarbrick, way out of his blue paint, elects to cover it up and take the whistle.
And this one's going to go down to the wire. It's been a tremendous game. Finally seeing a little bit more offense here. And Cornelison, the goal scorer, the defenseman, actually played a few years upstate, SUNY Potsdam. Had five goals during his collegiate career.
Raiden sends one towards the net. Nobody home there. Goes off the board. Toronto trying to clear. Goes off a body. Azara picks it up. Backhanded over. Guerra gets his stick lifted by Jesty. Stepping up in the neutral zone there. Captain Brian Monette puts it in on the goal. Swarbrick leaves it off. Jesty trying to make a play. It's turned over one more time. Loose in the slot. Swarbrick came diving out. He lost his stick. Azara has it now. Tries to cycle it to the far corner. Swarbrick gets his stick back. Marshall gets it out of the zone. Christopher Stubba back to pick it up. Azara's on the far blue line, banging his stick, looking for it. Tries to settle it down. It's still a 50-50 battle before McBay gets it pushed back to him. LeBlanc ahead. Waters collects on the east-west pass. Cuts in wide. To the front. Shot. Rebound. Another save is made. Might have went off a defender there. Reverse behind the net. Walking out Whitehead. Back door. Knocked away by the stick of Mattson. Bounces over McBay. Another shot comes through. Hits the back kick plate. It's free now, and Nassau's looking to get it out of their end. Ryan Keane enters Toronto zone, drops it off for Gonsalves. Gonsalves, back door. On the backhand, shot comes through. It gets blocked. Gumas has it. To the point, one-timer goes just wide.
And Travis, we saw Toronto still bringing the pressure, only up by one. That was actually their 40th shot of the game.
3:23 to go. Kevin Gumas with the puck now. Taking his time. Nassau making a little bit of a change. It's spun back around for Gumas. Gumas is going to carry. He's on his backhand. Loses the puck, loses his footing. Toronto has it now. Trying to stretch the ice. It enters. Hunter. Hunter drops it off. Hurley forces the turnover. He hits Gumas, but Gumas out of legs. Can't catch up to it. Cornelson loses an edge, loses the puck, and it comes out front. Swarbrick dives on top of it, and we get a whistle. 2 minutes, 50 seconds remaining in period number three. Toronto on top, 3-2 in this one. Steve Cornelson right now with the go-ahead goal, potential game-winning goal, and we're getting a timeout here from the Nassau County PD.
And I think that's a good timeout to call with under 3 minutes left. You know, you've gotten tremendous performances from both your goaltender, Steve Geichis, with 16 saves on 17 shots, Ryan Mattson, 21 saves on 23. But when you only put 18 shots on net, again, getting outshot 40-18, more than a 2-1 margin, it's hard to win hockey games.
You're right, Jack. So big chance here for Nassau County with 2 minutes, 50 seconds to go. Try to draw something up on this timeout. We're going to take a second here. Got a lot of sponsors in this event. We're going to try to mention them all throughout the two broadcasts here today. But first, we're going to start. Just want to thank our James Norris Memorial Trophy sponsors, Clinical Staffing Resources, Hollywood Health Club, The Ride by Hollywood, E310 L174 Snyder Island, Navaretta and Howard, Attorneys at Law, Dr. Matthew Cohen, the Nolan family, Lilies of Long Beach, the Ancient Order of Hibernians, D17, Pecknick and Schaefer, LLP. As we get back to action, we will mention all of our sponsors of this event throughout the two broadcasts, as I mentioned, here for the G2H Foundation, celebrating Gerrin Hagen. Toronto trying to lock things down here. 2.5 left. Kieran Hurley carries the puck, enters the zone, loses it, and dumped out there by Hannah. Goes all the way down, and it will be an icing. So a big faceoff coming up now for the police department, Jack.
And with 2:22 remaining, clock winding down, time running out, this is the type of opportunity you need in face-offs. So important. We say it all the time during our high school broadcasts. Obviously a bit of a different environment, but it holds true here.
Gumas in on the draw for Nassau. Tries to win it. Still in the feet there of Rowe. Nassau comes out with it. Capizzuto tries to fire to the net. It gets blocked. Puck pops up in to pick it up. Going to keep an eye on Mattson in the net there. Pistani shot goes through one more time. Blocker save made by Swarbrick. Clearing attempt successful there. Toronto looking to make a change. All five guys going off. Four guys, pardon me. Staying in on the forecheck was Will Hunter. Stretching the ice for Kieran Hurley. Hurley over to Gumas. Gumas drops it for Somonte. Will he get Hurley looking for Somonte? Couldn't find his tape. It was broken up there by Krasnowski. Trying to stretch for Whitehead, knocked out of play there by Evan Morrow. The long twig getting in the way of that one. Minute 24 to go here, third period. 3-2 the score in favor of the Toronto Fire. Nassau gonna have to try to get up the ice quickly and set things up. Puck is still 50-50 there. Goes back all the way back for Mattson, who was actually looking to head to the bench, get the extra attacker out there. Guerra's pass is picked off by LeBlanc. LeBlanc tries to center it for Whitehead. Goes in behind the net. Whitehead still with possession. He goes back door. LeBlanc bounces off his tape. Minute left here in the game. McVay cycles it. Toronto just maintaining possession here. Nassau needs the puck if they want to tie this thing up. To in the third period.
And Toronto does a great job just controlling possession. Travis able to really dictate the pace of this game. And if this is the final 42 seconds, you can't have that if you're the NCPD.
Now Nassau win the faceoff. Waters holds it in, though. Past the outreach stick of Morrow. Battle on the half boards. LeBlanc looking to come away with it. Morrow defending him. 30 seconds left. Behind the goal line now. Trying to come out with it is LeBlanc and Whitehead. 20 seconds left on the clock. Nassau still in their end, trying to clear. It's picked off in the slot. Across. Toronto just holding the puck. 10 seconds to go. Centering pass. Knocked away. McBay at the point. Walks in. Shoots. Blocked shot. Waters. Another shot gets blocked. 2 seconds and one. And that's going to do it. The Toronto Fire Hockey Club make the trip down from Canada. And they are victorious over the Nassau County Police Department. 3-2 in our first of two games here. Honoring Gerrin Hagen. The G2H Foundation. I want to thank the Toronto Fire Hockey Club for coming down here, making the trip, supporting the G2H Foundation, and of course thanking them for their service and everything that they do back in Toronto. I want to thank the Nassau County Police Department for everything that they do in our communities here on Long Island. Thank them as well for participating in this event and for supporting the G2H Foundation. Jack, any final comments to add before we take a quick break and get ready for game number two?
You know, this is normally where we talk about the game, but this was a fun one. You know, it was a 3-2 final. It was fun to watch a lot of high-level players in it, and it's all for a good cause. Again, Travis, really can't stress enough how important it is to donate to the G2H Foundation. They do tremendous work, and well, this has been a fun one. I think you covered everything else.
And you can find all the information for the G2H Foundation, I believe, in the bio of this broadcast. It should be in there as well. You can also good old Google G2H Foundation, Gerrin Hagen. Support this foundation, support the cause. Gerrin was a cherished member of this community here in Long Beach. He did a lot for the community, even as just an 18-year-old. Did a lot for this community and will always be remembered. It's great what we're doing here today as we see Toronto Fire and the NCPD get set to take a picture to remember this day, remember this game between the two sides. And before we head out for the conclusion of this first broadcast, I want to thank the rest of our James Norris Memorial Trophy sponsors, the Dooley family, Benny Fitness Fit Factory, Minnesota's VFW Post 1384, the Rockaway Firefighters Mini Bowl, Jetty Bar and Grill, E302 L155 Viper's Nest, King of the Beach Volleyball, the DiPietro family, the Long Beach Lifeguards, Jesse Gerhard Memorial Foundation, the Long Beach Polar Bears, the New York Fire Consultants, New York Fire Safety Institute, Duffy Construction, J. Bella Contracting, Empire Motor Group, Falciano Accounting Tax Pensions, Top Notch Lawn Care, Mammoth Painting, Monarch Photography, Tracy Fontaine, White Hot Image, E317 L165 B54 Sleepless Nights, of the G2H Foundation Day here in Long Beach. Toronto Fire Hockey Club coming out on top 3-2 over the Nassau County Police Department. On behalf of everybody here at the LI Sports Network, Travis Quigley, Jack Ziskin, I want to thank you for tuning in, sticking with us, and please stick with us for game number two. It should be a really exciting, fun contest between the FDNY as they prepare for their 50th annual game against the NYPD coming up on April 20th. And of course, the hometown heroes, the Long Beach Guardians. Don't miss any of the action. Travis Quigley, I'll be taking you through the call of that one. Thank you, Jack, for hopping on, doing color with me for this one. And thank you all at home for tuning in with us here on the LI Sports Network. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with the broadcast of the Guardians and the FDNY.